A very good morning, class 8. This is your computer teacher, Rudrajit Dasgupta. I hope you are all doing perfectly fine in this pandemic situation. So children, we have successfully completed the first chapter, the operating system. Now, we are going to proceed with a new chapter. It's going to be very interesting. It's a combination of maths with the computers. So, in a great interesting way, we will complete this chapter, but slow and steady. So let's start up this chapter. The chapter name is Spreadsheet Formula and Functions. Let's write it down. Now, from the very word spreadsheet formula and functions, you can understand that now we are going to use a new software in MS as Excel. In the computer now, we are going to use a new software called MS Excel. In computer, we are going to use a new chapter called MS Excel. Now see children, now what is the speciality of MS Excel? I'm going to tell you. MS Excel is actually, it is a part of the Microsoft Office. It is a part of the Microsoft Office where we store and keep the data in cell boxes. You will find out in MS Excel. These are the cells or boxes where we keep the data, like 2, 3, 31, 4, like this. Here we store and keep the cell data. Now, this process of storing the data in this particular cells is the method in MS Excel. Or we can say in MS Excel, we store various data in this cell boxes. Now, what are the cells? Now, the next question obviously comes into your mind, what are the cells? Now, let me tell you. Cell is the intersection of rows and columns. Now, these rows and columns, they intersect to form cells. Suppose these are two rows and these are two columns. These rows and columns, they intersect to form cells. See, this is a cell. This is a cell, 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 this is a cell. So, these rows and columns, they are intersecting to form the cells. Okay, just like now row. See children, this is called a row. See the marker, this marker when it is in a horizontal. Class, let me clear you the concept of the rows and columns. See children, this marker is kept in this position. That means it is in horizontal. This is called a row. And when the marker is in a standing position, it is called the column. Okay, this is a row, horizontal in sleeping. And this is the column in vertical standing. Just remember, Lord Vishnu, when he is sleeping in Sheshnag, he is considered to be horizontal. That is a row. But when he is standing on the lotus, he is standing straight, means he is vertical. So that is the column. Okay, this is the horizontal. This is the horizontal position which is called a row, and this is the vertical position which is called the column. And these rows and columns, they intersect to form cells. Till here you clear your concept, children. MS Excel is a software where we store and save the data in boxes called cells. And what are these cells? These cells are nothing but the intersection of rows and columns. And what are rows? Rows are the horizontal or sleeping lines. Whereas columns are the vertical or the straight line. Remember when Lord Vishnu is sleeping in the Sheshnag, he is in a horizontal mood. But when Lord Vishnu is standing on the lotus, he is standing straight. Means at that time he is in vertical position. That is a column. So these rows and columns, they intersect to form cells. See, they intersect to form cells. Okay, till here you clear your concept. The rows and columns, rows are the horizontals, columns are the verticals, and these rows and columns, they intersect to form cell boxes, and in these cell boxes we store the data. Now in MS Excel these cell boxes have a particular cell address. Now how is that possible? I'm showing you. Are you finding an interest in my class? Like this we can share our knowledge. Hope some good feedback will be coming from your side. Through that I can also upgrade myself, I can also upgrade my knowledge, because knowledge is nothing to be feel proud of. Knowledge is a thing that we must share. Okay, let's come to our topic. Let's start up. Children, here the rows are marked as 1, 2, 3. And the columns, they are marked as ABC. Just remember, rows are marked as 1, 2, 3, columns are marked as ABC. Now suppose here I am storing 2. In this box I am storing 2. So what will be the cell address? So the column name and the row number combination determines the cell address. So let me determine. The column name is A and the row number is 1, which is equal to 2. So see, in the column number A, we are stored, and in row number 1, we are storing the value 2. Remember, our cell address is determined by the column name and the row number. First the column name we will be mentioning, then the row number we will be mentioning. Okay, similarly here in this box I have kept 2. So what will be the cell address? First the column name A I have written, Then the row number I've written is equal to 2. So 2 is stored in A1 cell, where A1 cell stands for the A column first row. Okay. Similarly, it's interesting, isn't it? Now let's try some more. Here I am skipping 5. So how we will determine column name? Column name I have written. Column name. Here, what is the row number? 2. So in the cell address having column name, in the cell address having cell address B2, that means column name B, row number 2. We have the cell value 5. Okay. Similarly, let's take an example. I put 9 here. So now you determine what will be the cell address where this value is stored, 9. Very easy. Take the column name C. It is C. Take the row number 2. So C2 cell, how will you determine? Column name C, row number 2, this cell is there. Like this, we are determining the cell address. And how we will determining the cell address? First, the column name and then the row number. First, the column name, then the row number. This is the unique identification of a cell address. Children, in this video, till this much you clear your concept. Just let's get a rough brush out of today's video tutorial. Today we have understood that MS Excel is a part of the MS Office application. It is an application software where we store and save data in cell boxes. And what are these cells? These cells are nothing but they are the intersection of rows and columns. And what are rows? The horizontal lines, they are called the rows, just like this marker. And vertical lines, they are the columns. Just like when Lord Vishnu is sleeping on the Sheshnag, he is in the horizontal mood. He is in the horizontal condition, and when Lord Vishnu is standing straight on the lotus, he is in a vertical mood. So these rows and columns, they intersect to form the cells, and in these cells we store the values, we store the numbers, we store the data. And each cell has a unique cell address. And how this cell address is identified? By the column name and the row number. The rows are marked as A, B, C, D. The columns, they are marked as A, B, C, D. The rows are marked as numbers 1, 2, 3. The columns, they are marked as A, B, C. The rows are marked as 1, 2, 3. So, cell address means column name and the row number. Okay? Suppose in this cell, I have kept 2. So, what is the cell address? Column name A. Then the row number 1, 1. Like this. Okay? Suppose 5 is stored here. So first we will give the column name, that is the B column name, then the row number 2 is equal to 5. That means B2 cell, that means column name B, row number 2, we have the value 5. Like this. Okay. Children, till this much. Today in MS Excel, we have started up today till this basic thing cleared it up. Watch this video as much as possible. If you have any query, feel free to give us a reply or a feedback. That's all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day. See you in the next live class. Bye.